we can check out the form of Leeds and Wigan ahead of those games. This is the match postponed because of Leeds' involvement in the Cup final, and generally, it's a classic. Leeds have made a rip-roaring start to the season. Their 100% record is on the line here. Wigan find themselves outside the top six. It's vital they win this, their game in hand. And Adrian Lamb leads the Wigan Warriors out onto the field. Big game for them, and they're still crippled by injury, but the three-quarter line here is exactly the same as it was for the game against Bradford. Radlinski at full-back, then it's Carney, Aspinwall, Hodgson, Ainscoe, O'Loughlin and Lamb, who is the captain. The forwards, O'Connor, Newton is back, that's a boost. Sculthorpe's in for the injured Craig Smith. Johnson, Tickle and Nick Graham continue at the back of the scrum. It's Mark Smith, Sean Briscoe, Gareth Hock and Mark Roberts on the bench for coach Stuart Raper. Mark Smith, the eldest of those, at 21. Now the Leeds Rhinos, former Wigan star Gary Connolly at fullback, Calderwood, McKenna and Senior and Cummins, Maguire alongside Duneman. Bailey, Diskin and McDermott, once of Wigan, David Ferner, of course, with Wigan last year, Walker and Sinfield, who is the captain. And the Leeds bench is occupied by Burrow, Ward, Feather and Poaching, and the coach is Darrell Powell. And Kevin Sinfield, the Leeds Rhinos captain, leads his men and the mascots out for what is traditionally one of the great games of the Headingley season. Aiming for an eighth Super League victory, and they start this one as clear favourites. Undefeated, but it has taken last-minute drop goals in their last two games at Castleford and against Wakefield here to keep them at their 100%. Wigan, they have won just one of the last five matches, a 24-22 Good Friday Classic against St Helens. So who's going to take the spoils here, Leeds or Wigan?
Well, it's hard to decide between the two sides. OK, the Wigan youngsters really have stood up and been counted. Big night also for the official Steve Ganson. Wigan, of course, on their travels across the Pennines, normally struggling the opening 10-15 minutes, but Leeds, their cock-a-hoop, unbeaten in Super League. They'll want to keep it that way.
So it's Danny Tickle who will get this game underway. Wigan in the traditional red and white hoops, cherry red and white hoops, and Leeds in their gold and blue jerseys. And here is Chef Walker, the first tackle of the match. And an opportune moment before the action really gets going for us all, I think, to spare a thought for Matt Crowther, the Hull winger, who we saw tragically injured yesterday. And he is recovering in hospital after an operation on his leg. He has broken bones in his leg, plus he's got a broken ankle, we're told now. And what is more, it's his 29th birthday today. Not the best present, but Matt Crowther watching in his hospital bed. We're all thinking of you. Speedy recovery.
Well said, Eddie. And I think every rugby league fan will agree with you on that one. Hope you enjoy the game. And that's a silly penalty to give away early in the match. Obviously, the tactics given by Stuart Raper, the Wigan coach, is that they're going to try to turn Leeds over, what we call the turtle system. Try to slow them down at the play of the ball.
This is Chef Walker. He is turned on his back by a combination of three players. And here is Kevin Sinfield, a little half break. David Hodgson got to him. Tackle is completed by the Wigan centre. He missed the St Helens game on Good Friday.
Interesting to see there Kevin Sinfield, the lead skipper. Sometimes in plays that stand off. But you can see him running out wide, so he's obviously going to provide the pass for the fellas like this, Keith Senior.
Good tackle there by Martin Aspinwall on Senior. This is Duneman, that's a nice chip into open space. It was difficult for Radlinski to pick it up, but he made easy work of it. And here comes Radlinski now, but that's a good challenge on him by Chris McKenna.
Did well the Leeds defence there. They forced him out, made sure that he went across field. Didn't make much ground progress.
Vocal support here at Headingley from the occupants of the stand here immediately beneath us, the north stand.
Seems to be catching, doesn't it? They find a couple of guys with a big drum.
Injury here for Terry O'Connor. Big hit on him. And the Wigan prop forward is a bit groggy. Oh, it was high from Barry McDermott, his old mate.
Not too sure, Eddie. I think that came right across the chest. Well, he got the shoulder into his face.
Okay.
But the swinging arm certainly went across the chest. That's the reason why he's probably got away with it. But
five.
He gets up a little bit groggy.
Come on,
well, the two prop forwards, McDermott and O'Connor, great mates. That bounced off the head of referee Steve Ganson.
Refereeing as well there by Ganson, because if it had been an advantage to Wigan, who were the side that were kicking, then he would have put the ball in the scrum and make sure that Leeds had the chance of head and feed.
Got a right crack on the back of the bunch then, did Mr. Ganson. He turned round, looked for the ball, eventually found it. This is McDermott.
Wouldn't have hurt him.
Diskin. Diskin to Sinfield, and Sinfield just dropped the shoulder. Chev Walker's through the gap. Chev Walker, wide it goes to Calderwood. First try to the Rhinos. Great start for Leeds. Malcolm Reilly on his feet behind Darryl Powell. And Calderwood, what a wonderful run of form he's been in all through this year. That's his 13th try in all games now.
Well, I said the mere fact that the loose forward Kevin Sinfield was working out wide, not only to serve the centre, but also to provide the big second rower, Chev Walker, with a break. This was superb. Sheer class there. Just sucked the man to him, and off he went. Nick Graham, the loose forward, was absolutely confused with that. Look at this. See how he just pulls in the loose forward, Nick Graham. He came round on the angle, did Walker, and he did well. Soon as was being attended to and going down for the tackle, he offloads for the winger. That is superb rugby league football. Doesn't come much better. As we showed you a replay, the wink there from Calderwood means that he's in fine form, but what a delayed pass from the skipper, Kevin Sinfield.
Well, he hadn't scored in three matches, and more problems for Stuart Raper. Watching on the sideline, he was very confident, I must say, coming into this match. He said he doesn't believe that any club this year will go through the Super League unbeaten. There's only one, of course, with an unbeaten record so far, and he was hoping that tonight might be the night for the Wigan Warriors. Well, it's very early days yet, but Leeds off to a fabulous start. The kick, though, isn't clever from Sinfield, though it was difficult. It stays at 4-0. The Calderwood try.
See how he just pulls away, make sure that Graham goes with him. Look at the gap. Enormous gap there. That was outstanding rugby league football. He's back to his best, you know. The second row of Chev Walker. And so is this kid. Knows how to finish a try.
21 years of age, three times an England A international, a Great Britain international in waiting, Mark Calderwood. And Chev Walker, the man who created the try in the end with the last pass, he's only 20. He switched impressively to the pack this year. And his captain, Kevin Sinfield, is only 22. Rich future in store, I feel, at Headingley. Maguire was underneath the kickoff, and here's Ryan Bailey. Two more comparative newcomers there. Maguire 20 and Bailey only 19. Here's one of the older hands in Barry McDermott. His 200th appearance for Leeds tonight, by the way. This is David Ferner now.
He's not an old boiler then.
You said that. Maguire,
not.
McDermott.
That's good work from the wing forward as well.
That was going to be a penalty to Wigan because he played it horizontally.
Ball before the tackle was complete. Don't place the ball on the ground before the tackle's complete.
Gotta regain your feet first. Well, this is how they used to do it in the olden days.
Okay.
When I say the olden days, only last season. Rules have changed this year, of course. It's sometimes takes a while for the forwards to take it on board,
hold,
Eddie.
Hold. Yeah.
Well, that's twice you've insulted Mr. McDermott. Drive forward by Danny Sculthorpe. They get the ball away to Graham. Here's a chance here for Rainscoe. Flicks it back to Hodgson. Good cover defence from Leeds.
Well done.
Did well there, Calderwood. Didn't get sucked into coming away from the whitewash there on the touchline. He made sure he was going to keep his ground.
Good.
Another crunching tackle on O'Connor. Here is Adrian Lamb. Now it's Sean O'Loughlin. Big hit by David Ferner.
Third.
They come down the short side again. And this is Danny Tickle. He offloads to O'Loughlin. Good ball to Newton. And Newton has got a hole to hit. But passed it straight into the arms of Maguire. And Maguire comes away.
Golden opportunity just wasted there by Wigan.
just overcooked the pass, and now Tickle has overcooked the tackle.
Sheer desperation there and disappointment. There's the fact he had a bit of a stray knee as well, but you can see Tickle right over the top. Made no attempt to release the man wanting to play the ball. But what a golden opportunity. A neat little break by the hooker, Terry Newton. But the pass was astray. Well spotted though by Maguire.
McDermott to Bailey. Dropped 40 metres away from the Leeds dry line. Disc in at dummy half. Sinfield looks right and finds Gary Connolly. Connolly taking on Adrian Lamb. Lamb winning the battle with Hodgson. McKenna waits at dummy half. Drives the ball forward, McKenna. Good run.
Doesn't augur well for this Wigan defence because Leeds are making forward progress with ease.
That wasn't a good kick, though, from Diskin.
Chase was good, though.
It was gobbled up by Radlinski. Well, Leeds have not beaten Wigan here at Headingley. They have a penalty now. The Wigan, not standing square at the play of the ball. They haven't beaten Wigan here at Headingley in 3 years.
Not even got the ball away, did they? Straighten it up.
Sinfield just a little bit quick out of the blocks. We'll stand square until the ball has been played correctly. But they're up for this Leeds. Oh, that was a high one there.
Scunthorpe with the break.
Just shook it off, did Scunthorpe there, but certainly caught one for his corner.
Started six of the matches of 2003 now. Prop forward, Danny Scunthorpe. And Terry Newton goes wide to Nick Graham, who in turn finds Hodgson. And Newton again in at dummy half. Worth mentioning that Terry Newton is playing on and defying doctor's advice almost to continue here. He's got a bad knee injury.
Well, we saw him warming up about half an hour before the kickoff, and he appeared to be limping badly.
And he's bravely battling on for Stuart Raper and the Wigan cause.
That was forward.
It doesn't matter because Brian Carney, who also is an injured warrior with 15 stitches in that head wound on Friday, he couldn't take the pass in.
And at least the youngsters are trying to create the opportunity out wide there. There was no one at home, were they? No one was there. Francis Cummings had found himself absolutely stranded, and you saw Stuart Raper, the anguish on his face there. That's the second golden opportunity they've wasted.
Here now is Keith Senior. Talking of Stuart Raper, he has a fabulous record here at Headingley.
Knock on
against Leeds.
Well, I'm not so sure it was a knock on, or was it a bad play of the ball?
Have a look at Tim
Hughes
for that.
Yep, he's right, he's got it right. He lost it, but was it help with a knee?
Hang away, boys.
Let's have a look. Yeah, it was.
Ryan Edding.
Accidental, though.
By Nick Graham.
Graham was trying to get away. He wouldn't have known that his knee was in the way.
So here is a chance for Wigan to counter with Hodgson. And he offloads to Radlinski. Back it comes this way to Nick Graham. Nick Graham tracked down all the way by Calderwood. Quick play the ball, though, Newton. Here is Danny Scunthorpe again. Good drive in from Scunthorpe. 20 metres away, Wigan. Moving forward purposefully here with O'Connor.
Well, it's Leeds defence now that are hanging back. Wigan getting over the advantage line easy.
Adrian Lamb looking for a big game from him today, Wigan. And almost through there was Paul Johnson. He plays the ball. And here's a drive in for the line. And that's a try, I think, for Scunthorpe. He's got the ball down. Yes, he has. It's gone very quiet at Headingley, and Danny Scunthorpe has levelled the scores here. Well, they were moving forward in that set of six with real venom, the Wigan attack.
Full credit to them as well. They're a little bit shaky. Lost two opportunities back on the inside from Lamb. And then a quick play of the ball. Look at the defence, all at sea. There were six in that one area. Nothing that Sinfield could do about it. Scunthorpe charging onto the football. Well, if that try early in the game from Calderwood gave the impression that it was going to be easy for the Tykes, at Rhinos, should I say, look at that, that's a mistake. It was an accident, certainly not intentional from Nick Graham. And the Rhinos defence just fell apart. He'll be happy, and rightly so. He knows they're full of confidence, and why not? They've had two opportunities, they spurned them. Not on that occasion.
Danny Scunthorpe, who was actually here at Headingley very early on, but he went to Warrington as part and parcel of the deal that brought Yestin Harris to Headingley all those years ago. Didn't actually play for the first team, and he's played a little bit for Warrington, also for Rochdale, and now he's ended up at Wigan. And that's his second try of the campaign. This is Danny Tickle, meanwhile. Two goals from four against the Bulls on Friday. And that's one from one so far tonight. Wigan hit the front.
Well, so often they get caught there. Six players in the space of 8 metres or even less, 5 metres. Sculthorpe had to go high, tried to ball and all, but Sculthorpe showing a lot of strength there. And he came charging onto that football. It's not going to be easy. They will not lie down, this Wigan side.
Well, I mentioned Stuart Raper's great record at Headingley. It's worth mentioning they won a playoff here, or he won a playoff here, with Castleford in 1999. Won a Challenge Cup semi-final here last year with Wigan, plus the last three in the Super League with Wigan.
Second and good.
10 metres away from their own line, Wigan in possession with the try-scorer, Sculthorpe.
Third, good, hold. Come on, Kevin!
And here now is Danny Tickle, and Sinfield gets to him. Well, it was an early try from Leeds, and a wonderful response from Wigan, Phil.
Yeah, very positive opening in the first 10 minutes, and the two players you've just seen recently touched the ball, Terry O'Connor and Danny Sculthorpe, I think, are very much crucial to Wigan's chances of success here tonight. Many teams, you know, in Super League will actually select four front rowers or four props to play the game, two on the bench and two out there, and rotate them throughout the 80 minutes. Wigan, unfortunately, don't have that luxury here today, and a tremendous pressure, really, on Terry O'Connor and Danny Sculthorpe to play for maybe 60 or 70 minutes in this game and play very well in doing so.
Well, they were the two in on the tackle then, on Francis Cummins, and there is Sculthorpe again, and he was watched by O'Connor, who is in close attendance. This now is Chev Walker, and Wigan have certainly been encouraged by that try from Danny Sculthorpe. Chev Walker injured there as he plays the ball gingerly. Here now is Ferner, and Walker down on his haunches, and the big hoof downfield from the captain Sinfield, but Radlinski positioned himself perfectly, and the Wigan and Great Britain fullback will run it forward. Good chasing though by Andrew Duneman. What a buy he has been.
He certainly paid off out of the transfer fee that he wouldn't know would have cost them, but with the two drop goals over the past couple of weeks, it's ensured that Leeds stay top of the table undefeated. That should have been a penalty.
Carney tried to get one, but
he touched Ferner, and Ferner hadn't gone back the 10.
Newton, and here's Lamb. Wide it goes to Graham. Good kick, and a great race through here by Ainsco, but picked up by Connolly. We can know all about him, of course.
Nice attacking ploy as well. They're getting it just right. Forwards leading
knock
the way.
Knock on, they're claiming. The ball has come out, and a knock on is given against Chris McKenna.
Well, they really squeezed him, didn't they?
You last.
And bounced him down. It was always going away from him.
Wait there. Okay, hang on.
Well, how many times do we see a side going with such a beautiful start to the game? And it was a great try, no doubt about that. Sinfield created it. Walker passed it on to Calderwood. And then they just start to go to sleep. And that's the impression I get at the moment from Leeds.
Aspinwall with the drive in, and the tackle made by Keith Senior. Carney and Tickle.
Second, come on, Barry.
This is getting closer.
This is good work by the Wigan forwards.
Sculthorpe drives it in again. Oh, an offload, but straight into the arms of Diskin, and Chev Walker's got a big problem. And there's a bit of a punch-up as well behind Chev Walker, because McDermott went a bit high. It's broken up now. Senior offloads to Duneman.
Well, this Wigan outfit are giving them plenty.
Second, okay,
and Chev Walker is in all sorts of problems with a shoulder, I think. McDermott now.
They mean business to the Warriors tonight.
This is Ryan Bailey trying to go over the top of Adrian Lamb, who did well, stood his ground. Diskin, wide to Sinfield. O'Connor got to him, he was finished off by Hodgson. Last tackle here for Leeds. It's with Maguire. Now it's with Dooneman. He puts the kick in under pressure. It's come up for Ferner. He's fed senior. There's a chance here for Leeds. Ball inside to Carr. Brilliantly taken. Cummins brilliantly taken. And that will be a try for Leeds. Cummins with the try. One of the most consistent performers in Super League over the years. This is 157th consecutive appearance, Francis Cummins. And brilliant skills in midair here to take in the pass through to Ferner.
Dooneman's little chip over the top there. Knew exactly where it was going to go. And Ferner just fed it as soon as he got it. Knew he had the speed. What great hands there from the experienced winger, Francis Cummins. But the combination, the little chip over. Just had a check to see if they're onside, and they certainly were. No sweeper being employed by the Wigan outfit. You can see there that Carney was left right out on his own. And that was wonderful vision from this man, Francis Cummins. Knew that senior perhaps didn't have the legs to get in at the corner. But watch how the way that Dooneman decides, right, they're all onside, no doubt about it. No one had dropped back, but Ferner said, this guy's quicker than me, Khan is left. But the way that Cummins came back on the inside, not close, but at a sharp angle towards the sticks. Well, two great tries from Leeds. And the Sculthorpe effort, that was good work from the forwards. We're in for a classic, Eddie.
I think we are, and Francis Cummins, that's his 14th try against Wigan over the years for Leeds Rhinos. And Kevin Sinfield now with the opportunity. He's through 100 goals for Leeds now. Captain of the 1998 Academy Grand Final winning side against Wigan. The heir apparent, many people call him, to Andy Farrell. But he's missed with another kick. Well, since that semi-final when he kicked one off the touchline. And I know that he didn't miss with anything at Cardiff, but it's not been crushed since.
There you see there, look how Cummins has already made a decision. Whilst the sweeping defence is going across for senior, off they go. He goes back on the inside, should have been trailed. Great vision though by the winger.
Kevin Sinfield, have a word with Barry. All right, I'm just telling you, you know.
Cummins, great try. But Kevin Sinfield,
onside, lads.
That's two misses with the boot. Well, we Maguire's saw, underneath the kickoff.
So at Castleford, didn't we, that Hull paid the price for not having a goal kicker on top form.
Indeed so. Substitutions. Three of them by Leeds. Ward, Feather, poaching all on.
Interesting to see the referee, Steve Ganson, whilst Wigan were just shaping up for the kickoff, he shouted out to Kevin Sinfield and said, now, listen, Kevin, have a word with Mr. McDermott. Tell him to calm down. So the message is out.
Here's Danny Ward. Set, good. Diskin. Leeds have made three changes already. Wigan yet to make an alteration to their starting lineup. Remember, there are 12 changes allowed from the men on the bench. And that includes Bloodbins, of course. Chip over the top. Oh, and Carney and Radlinski leaving it to each other. And eventually, Carney gets it to Radlinski.
Excellent kick there from Dooneman yet again. Well weighted.
Well, Steve-O reckons we're in for a classic. What say you, Phil?
I'd agree so, although they need one or two of the other Wigan forwards there just to get in and help. I think this 20-minute stage used in a game is, as we've seen with the Leeds side, when coaches tend to rotate, bring on a couple of fresh players. Wigan maybe haven't chosen to do that just yet, and they need players like Brian Carney and other fellow backs to get in and just roll the sleeves up. It's important that Wigan play territory as much as they can in the Leeds half, because we've just seen the quality on show. The skill of that last try was absolutely outstanding, and it's one of the reasons why they're still at the top of the Tetley Super League after eight rounds.
Great break here from Terry Newton. He's got Radlinski in support. What an important tackle that was from Sinfield.
What a great run from the hooker, who's all is out there on one leg, Eddie.
And here's Newton again at the heart of it. Gets the ball away to Graham under pressure. Good hands. Hodgson wide to Ainscoe. Ainscoe goes in. Ainscoe goes in the corner. What a Wigan try.
Okay. Check that grounding,
and he wants just to check the grounding, Steve Ganson.
Just have a look
no
at the
problem with
at the
it.
End.
That was an right, excellent winger's out. Try. He knew they were coming across. Watch him crouch down. No worries at all. Yep. No sign of his foot on the whitewash. That's a great try. Wants to look and see whether he maybe touched the corner flag, but no, it was down first. Actually, a bit of an advantage. You see how the corner flag is leaning over. If it had been straight, you know, that might have been a bit dodgy, but it's try time.
It is for Jamie Ainscough. He got a try after just 42 seconds on Friday against the Bulls. He's taken a little bit longer to get on the score sheet tonight, but Ainscough in the corner. I think we are in for a classic here, absolutely right.
A little bit of deja vu here, isn't it, that Leeds score yet again and then Wigan come back and bounce away. They were caught there, no one at home, but it was all came from the break from Newton. And he was quick to get it away. Good hands as well. Well, Lachlan got it on the burst, and this fella finished off well. Caught on the hop. Whoa! Don't move.
Jamie Ainscough. Try, as I say, against the Bulls on Friday. He'd missed the previous four. Two tries here last August, by the way, for Jamie Ainscough, so he knows his way to the try line at Headingley. Tickle now with a very difficult kick. Couldn't be closer to the touchline on that far side. ...25 metres away from the line, but it's the angle that makes it so difficult. But what a kick from Tickle! Well, will it be the difference between the two goal kickers tonight? Tickle has been dead-eye with both of his. Senior's missed both of his, and the gap's 4 points.
There's any substitutes, there's Ward and Feather, and look at the gap and the space that they allowed Newton to run through. Did well to keep it alive. Quick pass there from the standoff, Sean O'Loughlin. But what a finish. He knew he was in. All the experience in the world, this fella.
Well, here is Sinfield to restart the match, and from a Leeds point of view, he will hope that he will get his goal-kicking boots polished in a moment. If he gets another opportunity, and the way this match is going, I think he probably will. But Wigan ahead by 12 points to 8.
Second now move.
Well, it's been a horrific run for injuries for this Wigan outfit. We've already heaped praise on this Wigan youngsters that they've had to bring through. Stuart Raper has just had to throw him right in at the deep end. But
just
boy,
as,
no
just
one
as Leeds
sunk.
Have done over the past few years.
But they haven't sunk any, have they?
No,
they're,
they have
swimming,
not.
They're swimming strongly.
The defence has been a bit of a problem for Wigan this year. 27 tries conceded before tonight. Plus 6 in the Challenge Cup semi-final against Bradford. So I think we're going to be in for a bit of a points festival here, the way the opening 20 minutes or so have gone. This is Connolly. Good run from the Lance Todd Trophy winner.
Quick thinking, running from the dummy half.
Here's Danny Ward. 20 metres away now.
He's lost it.
He has. And Diskin complaining to the touch judge it was stolen. And Darrell Powell looking concerned.
So he should. Produced absolutely two super tries. And just lost control. Maybe helped along its way. But it shows you that sometimes when you do make substitutions, I mentioned the fact Danny Ward, Chris Feather came in off the bench very early in the fact that they were all at sea in that defensive line, allowed Newton the opportunity to create that try. Plenty of talent in this Wigan outfit, don't worry.
There is, and here is Danny Tickle. Let's take a look at how it shapes up over the years, and as you can see, Wigan with almost twice as many victories as the Leeds Rhinos, and at Leeds, they still hold sway in Super League. It is still Wigan's. So Leeds have it all to do here. This is Hodgson. That's good defence.
Did well to keep in there. Went right to the ground straight away. Knew he was on for the whitewash.
Lamb with a kick over the top on the last. And that will bend its way to the touchline. And Chef Walker's off the field, of course. It looked like he'd sprung a shoulder or something. Bill, what's on?
You're getting very good at this, Eddie. That's just about on the ball, that one. Chef Walker disappeared immediately to the medical room. He's back out, as you can see, that left shoulder, ice on top of it. He's hoping to return. Leeds are hoping that he's going to come back. And that was the impact on Danny Sculthorpe. And incidentally, Sculthorpe just really emphasising the enthusiasm in the Wigan camp. He was replaced a few moments ago by Gareth Hawk, and he didn't want to come on. He said, I'm fine, I'm enjoying this. I think Wigan are at the moment.
That's a penalty, though. It's been wall all over the top of the grounded player, Calderwood.
Well, it won't be pleasing, Stuart Raper. The scoreline will, but not giving away a penalty like that. So often sides, good kick and chase, get them confused, and yet they give away a silly penalty.
Well, they've scraped home in the last two, have Leeds, just to the Andrew Duneman drop goal, Castleford and Wakefield. This is poaching.
Well, I must say, there's no real bite from either defence. Attack is becoming supreme at the moment.
Maguire, wide it comes, Senior, little dummy, that's a great tackle by Aspinwall. Cerner at dummy half. Maguire again. Tickles after him, and O'Connor finishes him off. Last tackle. Connolly. Duneman wide to Sinfield. Gets the kick in, and the ball came off a Wigan player, but it's the turnover.
He was caught in two minds there, the lead skipper, Sinfield. He was going to take the power play and then decided, no, I better go for the kick. He really should have put that into the corner. That's what Wigan have been doing. Every opportunity they've been in this Leeds attacking quarter.
Great ball wide. Here is Ainscough. Oh, he said it's forward, Mr. Ganson.
Oh, that is dubious. Well, Calderwood's upset. I'll tell you the reason why, because he was caught short. He was caught completely out of position. And there's the man that somewhat late with his flag.
Mark, we're touch judging back play. We're not wired up, so I've got to rely on his signal.
I'll tell you what, Calderwood will
he's
be a relieved man.
He's in a better position there than me.
Because you can see there, it gone away from the whitewash, and once the pass, which was superb, well, I've seen these given.
Here we are.
Nothing wrong with that, as far as I'm concerned. That's the momentum rule.
Okay.
See?
Lock in.
Well, I don't think it's even momentum. I think that was a perfectly legitimate pass.
Well, you add that momentum to it.
Duneman, it's a good run. Aspinwall gets to him in the end. And then there was all this going on, and then Ainscough got a bit upset. But it's Leeds who are on the charge here.
That is every right to be upset. But deep down, I'll tell you, it was Calderwood that was...
Feather looks for support. Ferner clatters to the ground.
Radlinski came out of nowhere.
Here is Sinfield. Dabs the kick over again. The ball has bounced very unkindly for Wigan. And I think... Well, I was going to say, I think they've knocked that ball dead, but they haven't. Dead. It went dead.
Pretty close. This is a better option. It was a poor kick before from Sinfield.
First.
Got the right bounce. No, I did right. Ainscough put his body between... on rushing traffic and the football. That's experience for you.
Come on.
Well, if you like fast open football, keeping the ball alive, this is for you tonight.
Yes, it's entertaining stuff. No doubt about that.
Good lad.
Half an hour gone. 10 to the half time break. Graham wide. Hodgson.
Four.
Adrian Lamb. Here's Nick Graham. Sean O'Loughlin, good ball back to Tickle. Chris Feather was waiting for him, good offload. And O'Loughlin does well again to get it away to Radlinski.
There again, we see no bite in this defensive line from Leeds. Great little chip over.
Wonderful chip. Oh, really? The ball has bounced here.
Oh, it's a knock-on.
Well, the referee hasn't given it, and Tickle will go over. He'll go to the video referee to have a look.
Knock-on from Lamb,
the advantage
sadly.
Run. Want to check if there's
but
a knock-on from
Adrian
Lamb after
the kick. Shows the enthusiasm yet again, and I think that the replay will show that Lamb comes out there on the left-hand side. Watch him get a fingertip to it.
And I think that came off his knee, Steve-O.
Well, if it is, it's a try then. I thought it came off his hand. Well, it's hard to say. I think you might be right. Well, this could be try time. Wigan are confident. They're going back.
Happy with everything.
What a great take. And Tickle, he was in for it there. Well, he's one guy that really has shown up very, very well. He's onside. It looked a knock-on for me, but in the slow-motion replay, it comes off the knee of Adrian Lamb. They're all onside. Newton picks it up. This will be TRY. Leeds are in trouble.
Try is given. It came off the knee, and Tickle was there to capitalise off Terry Newton's pass. And right next to the post, well, Wigan are rocking the league leaders here.
Well, it looked for all the world in fast action that it was a knock-on. But as they slowed it down, and a wonderful example from this Wigan outfit of playing to the whistle. Leeds were hanging around expecting the knock-on to be called. The skills there from the standoff for Lachlan. But look at the pickup there from Newton. I mentioned earlier, Newton is travelling on one good leg and he's not impressed.
The three wise men, Mick Cook, Darrell Powell, Malcolm Reilly. And not a smile between them. Tickle then, coming up here, there they are, all making a note for half-time, and Tickle adds the extras to his own try. 18 points to 8, 100% Leeds are backs to the wall.
This is lazy defence. Two at the marker, three with their backs to the opposition, and the reason why they score is because they are on the backward motion. What great skills, though, from this young standoff. Play to the whistle. Half the lead side has said, oh, this will be a knock-on. And Tickle comes up with a belter.
And here is the try scorer now to run the ball back from the kickoff. 7.5 to half-time.
Well, Darrell Powell will be itching to get at his charges there at the half-time break, mainly due to the fact because they really have been dominant in their forward pack this season. They've laid the platform, but I'm afraid it's the other way around at the moment. It's Wigan that are controlling things.
And three more changes by Leeds. They're getting through their substitutions here. And Wigan with confidence to burn. This is Nick Graham. Well, that's forward.
Well, forward. Quite much anyway. Well, this could be a big relief for Leeds. I think the reason why we're having so many substitutions is that Darrell Powell is totally confused. Because nobody, and I mean nobody on the Leeds outfit, that's packing down into this scrum, have rolled up their sleeves and said, hey, come on, we've got to show our power. This isn't touch and pass, boys. This is a real thing.
Six changes made by Leeds. We're not at half-time yet. This is McKenna.
Just shows how desperate he is, Darrell Powell. He wants some spark.
Rob Burrow might provide it, poaching.
But it's the forwards that need to do the work. That's where they're being let down.
Good run there from poaching. He had Graham on his back. Here's Burrow. Here's Ryan Bailey.
Much better.
McDermott is waiting. It goes back, though, to Sinfield. Here is Duneman. Now Senior. He's broken through one tackle of O'Loughlin. But the reinforcements came. Burrow, not the best. Duneman on the bounce, looking to get it out wide. Oh! Oh! What a mess.
Touchdown's got the flag up, said he hit the line. Touch. It's no good arguing. Mr. Calderwood, the guy in the green and black stripes, is not going to change his mind, irrespective of whether he's got it right or not, which I think he's got it wrong.
Okay.
Yep.
Wigan head and feed.
I thought the back of the boot was off the white line.
Well, the Leeds fans agree with you, and so does Calderwood. Tough to tell, though, isn't it?
It's easy for us anyway. To the naked eye, for the touch judge, the boot was over, hanging over. Whether it touched the whitewash or not, well, it's pretty hard. Can't point the finger at the money flag waver.
Come on, get on with it.
Here's Carney.
They're bossing it, Wigan. They're showing a lot more enthusiasm, and maybe that big. This is at normal speed. And how on earth could you pick that up?
Keep working, Willie.
In fact, to be fair, I struggled in slow motion.
Adrian Lamb a bit groggily. He plays the ball to Newton. Here is Nick Graham. Well, that's not the best pass, but they got away with it, Wigan, somehow.
Well, they're more eager.
And it's on the last tackle here. And there's the dab over the top by Sculthorpe. It's a cracker. Oh, it was nearly a cracker. Well, Wigan have rocked Leeds back on their heels, haven't they, Clarkie?
Yeah, it doesn't surprise me, Eddie. You know, in many ways, this is almost a grand final elimination match for Wigan. If they don't win here, it'll be very, very difficult for them to finish high enough in the league to give themselves a chance in the playoffs. I think that's reflected really with the enthusiasm. I think Terry Newton has been inspirational for them in the opening stages, and really they've been quickest to everything. I think Leeds, though, will be disappointed with their first half performance. On four occasions, they've come up with mistakes whilst in possession. Three times they've knocked on, and once Barry McDermott was penalised, not playing the ball correctly. And really, that's what's made life so hard for his first half. They are also maybe the side that's more tired. Of course, the cup final, the game on Friday, and that may be the reason why Daryl Powell has chosen to make more substitutions to try and ignite this side into life.
Yes, maybe so. Dunaman, meanwhile, is pushed back into his own half. Burrow at dummy half. Maguire wide to Sinfield again. Oh, and it went straight through the arms of McKenna. And they're having a bit of a mare over there on that far side, I'm afraid.
Not the best pass, but once again we see this flat attack. Nearly all the sides do it.
Don't come into we're ready.
Sometimes it's a great advantage just to hang back that extra metre. He knows it too.
Kevin Sinfield, who of course is the Leeds captain, and not too much has been made of the decision to spurn the opportunity of the penalty goal in the cup final late on that would have rescued the day maybe for the Leeds Rhinos, but I wonder whether he's being affected psychologically by that decision or not.
Well, he's a tough hombre and he's calm and calculating. Let's hope that it isn't, but that came a knock-on, I thought, from Connolly. Either way, Wigan have got it, and Leeds are in all sorts of trouble. That's obstruction, is it?
Because you went behind David Hudson.
Came back on the angle, and spotted by the official. He's a bit confused. It's Stuart Raper. You can see there that, even though he didn't touch him, man, he certainly impeded Kevin Sinfield. Well, he wants it the same score. He wants that 10-point advantage to go into half-time. He knows these are nervous moments. Leeds are desperate. If they've got a plan move, this is when they should use it.
First.
Seconds ticking away.
Indeed so. Maguire, McDermott, through one.
That's better. Power, that's what they need.
Dunaman, Ferner. And Burrow to Bailey. Spins away from Johnson. Can't get away from the next man. Burrow, Maguire, Sinfield. Poaching just slipped. Graham was able to halt the progress. Last tackle here.
Surely a kick into the corner. Maguire's there.
Danny Maguire, good dab. No really enthusiastic chase. And, well, he did well, the Wigan defender.
Everything was right there. The kick was superb. Both the Wigan person going for the football had to move forward, but it moved a lot quicker than what the Leeds players did.
Now they have a penalty because of the use of a forearm by Ryan Bailey.
Well, he only went for the tackle. Looked to me as though it was Maguire that gave him the facial. That's why he looks a little bit confused as the big forward.
That, come on.
Well, a lot of these Leeds players have had plenty to say to the official, okay. Mr. Ganson. I think they realise that words will be said to them at half-time from Mr. Powell, and rightly so. They take nothing away from this Wigan outfit.
Come on, Barry.
They've been superb.
Good, hold
and Daryl Powell's face tells its own story. Oh, that's a brilliant kick from Lamb.
Oh, it's a shame that it didn't come up. Why on earth did Calderwood go for the football?
He'll play the knock-on, and that will do us for the first half. Well, he tried to hack it forward. He tried to kick and chase Calderwood, to be fair to him, because he knew that the time was ticking away. But what a little chip over the top that was from Lamb. And he tried to hack it downfield, Calderwood, and he backed himself to win the race. The race never came. It's half-time, and Leeds, who got off to a glorious start with Calderwood's try, gradually went into their shell. They haven't kicked a goal yet, Tickler's kicked three. He's converted all three tries. And it's the Wigan Warriors who are ahead by 18 points to 8 at the break.
This summer, Sky Sports brings you the hottest action.
The US Open.
See the world's number one Tiger Woods defend his title.
The best of the PGA European Tour.
The US PGA Championship and the World Golf Championships.
Golden League Athletics.
One of the biggest events in tennis, the US Open. Plus, the ATP Masters and the Nottingham Open. The hottest action this summer on Sky Sports.
This is it.
Until May the 7th, with Nectar multipoints, there are loads more Nectar points up for grabs. You could even earn double points with any Nectar sponsor. Nectar multipoints, out there now. Rewards are sweeter with Nectar.
Are you ready to see yourself as others see you?
I didn't know I was so grey.
Just for Men takes off the years grey puts on. Shampoos away grey fast and now has vitamins. Brings back a thicker, healthier, natural look.
I like what I see.
Just for Men takes off the years.
Discover England's Northwest. Call 08453 665555 for a free brochure.
Gina? You know, when I was first hired, we didn't have all these fancy integrated systems. Our sales program wasn't even linked with accounting. Warehouse platform in Chicago wasn't linked to anything, not even shipping. Back then, orders took days. Now, they just take hours.
Wow, how long have you been working here?
A couple of months now.
With Microsoft software, you can quickly connect all aspects of your business. That's software for the agile business from Microsoft.
Every day, Royal Mail helps the financial services industry reach millions of customers. Every day, our special delivery service guarantees valuable packets arrive quickly and safely. Every day, we deliver over 80 million items for the UK's top businesses. We are the real network, and we make business work.
Vodafone Live, you can send pictures to email addresses and any other mobile network. Vodafone Live.
There's a great choice of live football coming up this weekend on Sky Sports. Saturday we've got the First Division playoff semi-finals. It's the first leg between Nottingham Forest and Sheffield United. That's from midday, and at 5:30, Wolves take on Reading. That's live on Sky Sports 1. On Sunday, we've got the final day of the Premiership. Join us on Sky Sports 1 from 1 for the build-up of three live matches. Birmingham taking on West Ham. They'll be fighting against relegation. Chelsea and Liverpool battle it out for a place in the Champions League. And Bolton fight to stay in the Premiership against Middlesbrough. Here at Headingley, Leeds are fighting to hold on to their 100% record. But Wigan are intent, by the looks of things, on taking it off them. Darryl Powell's face was like thunder when he went into that dressing room. And there he is, just on the right of your screen, delivering what he hopes will be the magical team talk to get them going in the second half. Stuart Raper, meanwhile, is animated, and why shouldn't he be? 18 points to 8, the Warriors lead at half-time. He's really giving it some, isn't he, Stuart? He looks really, really animated, as I said. And, well, why shouldn't he be? Because that's a terrific first half that Wigan have just produced. Now, you may remember on Good Friday, when we watched Wigan beat St Helens, young Kevin Brown, he had a game of his life. He didn't quite make the Man of the Match award, but he did get the promise of a watch from Mr Stevenson. And today, the man who actually dug deep into his own pocket, bought young Kevin a watch, and just before the kickoff, made the presentation to him. Well, he looks suitably impressed. He's got the looks of a child choir boy, not you, but him. He was well pleased, wasn't he?
And he should be. It's a very nice watch, and it was indeed a great pleasure to give it to one of the up-and-coming players. And the players on this Wigan side certainly have done him proud, haven't they? He's the 18th man today, but I must say that Leeds look like a side that want to build a mansion. They're riding high at the top of the table, but they forgot to make sure that the foundations are there. It all started well. That was superb play by Sinfield to put Walker through. It was a big blow for Walker to leave the field of play. Calderwood, and a lot of people perhaps thought, uh-oh, Leeds at home, they are really on fire. But as I mentioned before, you cannot come up with mistakes like this. This one was senior, but it was poor defence that allowed Sculthorpe in for their try. There were six in attendance, all close quarters. Sculthorpe's strength did the way. But this was quality too. Again, champion stuff, isn't it? Nice take from Ferner. Dunham's chip was superb. Great positional play by Cummins. And the Glory Boys were back in town. But boy, oh boy, by huff and puff, we blow the houses down, don't we? And Newton was there. Quick hands out wide. Ainscough squeezes in at the corner. And they were in a lot of trouble. So much trouble that what I thought was a knock-on, and when they slowed it down, the slow-motion replay, beautiful stuff there by the standoff, and it comes off Lamb's knee. I thought it was his hand. Leeds were waiting for the whistle. Newton, who, as I said, is playing with one leg, sends Tickle in for the try, and one Stuart Raper will have a very big smile on his face. I just don't get the impression that Mr. Powell will be thinking the same.
We're going to hear to huff and puff and blow the house down from one big bad wolf. Let's go down to the three little pigs on the sideline. Clarkie, it's all yours.
Well, they've just probably blown the roof off and they're only halfway of doing the job. But I think that Leeds will certainly look to improve tremendously in the second half. Do you know, when you look at the fact they've won the last two Super League games by just 1 point, and they've shown great patience in doing that, they can hang on in there through the tough games and show just enough to get a win. This would be a great test for them here today. But Wigan are playing with a side who know these 2 points are vital to their chances of keeping 2003 alive. And the 1, 7 and 9, Rydlinski, Lamb and Newton, have been inspirational for the younger players around them.
Thanks, Phil. Yes, it is absolutely vital to Wigan to maintain their bid for a place in the top six come the end of the season. Right, now then, let's go down to the sideline again. Two more little pigs, Bill and Tony Ray, because Tony Ray, of course, London Broncos next up, aren't they, Bill? And Tony's taking a very, very close look at the opposition, Leeds.
That's right, Eddie. It's Leeds for the Broncos on Friday night at Brentford. Tony Ray is here. Sean McRae is here as well in the crowd, keeping an eye on these Rhinos. Everybody wants to look at the unbeaten side. What have you made of it so far?
I've enjoyed it, actually. I think it's a pretty even contest. It's three tries to two at the moment, so it's not too far out of Leeds' grasp, but I think they're playing really well in patches, so they're obviously a quality side.
Do you get the impression that they're not playing as well as they could?
Oh, I think it's even, you know. Most games in Super League have been like that, sort of this stage of the game, getting towards half-time, it's been pretty even. So they'll be regrouping now, and we'll see how they go second half.
Well, you had another great win on the road at the weekend at Huddersfield. Are we going to see the Broncos win at home on Friday night against this Leeds side?
Well, that's what we're working towards. Obviously, we're going very confident. We trained well this afternoon, so that was good for us. It's important to get that right, and the guys will just be resting up tonight and have a day off tomorrow, and then we'll warm into the game on Friday night. But that's the plan. We're looking for some momentum after a good result for us on Sunday against a quality team in Huddersfield. So high-quality team again on Friday night. We aim to do the same.
Thanks, Tony.
Thanks.
Wonder if you'll be smiling on Friday night. The Broncos are expecting their biggest crowd of the season for the visit of the Leeds Rhinos to Brentford. It's a 7:30 start on Sky Sports 1. The game itself will kick off at 8 o'clock, so plenty of time for you if you're working in the capital, if you're driving down from Leeds, to get there in time for the big kick-off. It's an 8 o'clock kick-off, but we are with you Friday night, 7:30, Sky Sports 1. And Sean McRae, who, as Bill said, is in the stand tonight taking a good look at Leeds, he will be our guest on the programme. OK, someone tonight will go home with the Tissot Watches Man of the Match. If it's going to be a Leeds player, he will have to perform out of his skin in the second half to take it home. Wigan, there might be one or two candidates there already. Steve Owen and Phil Clark will make their choice during the course of the second 40 minutes. And what a second half it will have to be for Leeds if they are to preserve this 100% record at the top of the table. They trail at the break by 10 points.
Je veux jouer à joue contre vous, mais vous le voulez-vous? De tout cœur, je veux gagner ce cœur à cœur. Vous connaissez mon jeu par cœur, alors défendez-vous. Sans enfer, je vais t'assurer un enfer de griffes et de crocs. Tu crieras bientôt au secours. Alors décidons de ton sort. Pour m'éviter quelques remords, je t'aimerai plus fort. Oh oui!
Oi, Churchill!
Yes?
Do people realise just how much money they could save on car insurance?
Mahoney?
Cut! Do people realise just how much money... Mahoney...
Oh, it's money! Come on, what are you all laughing at?
Do people realise just how much money...
You did have your tape on, didn't you?
Well, that was all right, wasn't it? I think that went well.
Very funny.
See how much you could save. Give the dog a phone on 0800 200 300. That's 0800 200 300 now.
New Cart Door Fruit and Fresh. A unique, refreshing blend of dairy ice cream and fresh yogurt, swirled with strawberries, red currants and raspberries.
If it's not fruit and fresh, show him the cart door.
Hi.
Come on, Bull. Time to go.
Go? Go where?
The old people's home. They'll look after you now. It's for the best.
Are you mad? I'm 55.
I know, but I've had a word with them. They'll take you. Come on.
Get off. Why should I go living in old people's home?
Because I want to put a snooker table in your bedroom and the kids are frightened of your moustache. Now, come on. Avanti.
Now there is no up or down. Introducing Mach 3 Turbo. Total comfort, shaving down or up. A new anti-friction coating on all three blades, plus a strip with more lubrication. So even against the grain, you get less irritation and the closest shave. Mach 3 Turbo, new from Gillette.
Friday! A bottle at last was saved!
Mm-hmm.
now you'll get to know another achievement of our Western civilization.
Oh, yes, sir.
I'll just pour the liquid into the sea and I'll send a message in the bottle.
Oh, Robinson, this is Red Bull. Much better than a message in a bottle.
Red Bull? You can't swim on a bull, Friday. We need a ship.
Not swimming, Robinson. Flying. Have you never heard? Red Bull gives you wings.
Oh, now what are we going to eat?
Oh, didn't I mention I'm a cannibal?
The air, the sea, the sand, where better for a short break than the seaside?
Here, that's where. We've got the architecture, the style, the nightlife.
No. You don't want all that on a break. You want to slow down a bit.
Absolute nonsense. Stick to dry land and stretch those legs.
And get blisters? If you want the perfect break, you want to take the weight off your feet.
Make up your own mind. Call 08454 56 56 56 for your England brochure.
Shall we begin with an astounding revelation? A moment of truth? A thing of beauty? Perhaps throw in some spectacular twists? Oh, is this the end? No, just the beginning. You know how it goes. The plot thickens. The hero rises. The crowd goes wild. Then a breathtaking crescendo. You wanted to be entertained, didn't you? It's all on Sky.
Well, the second half about to get underway here at Headingley, and at Leeds, their 100% record is under threat more than ever before this season. They stand proudly at the top of the table, but Wigan were just outside the top six at the start of play tonight. But this first half has been a team on display from the JJB Stadium who are hell-bent on getting into the playoff spots. And I mean, it would be a major surprise if they didn't, but with all the injuries they've had, a lot of people were tipping them to drop out of the six altogether, Steve-O.
Well, the fact is that if Leeds had beaten them by 15 points, they would have actually dropped another place. London would have pushed them out. So it was a big incentive for this Wigan outfit to play well tonight.
There's no sign that they will win by 15 points so far, but Darryl Powell will be hoping that the magical words at half-time in the dressing room will have worked. We shall see.
Well, they need power. They need strength. They need to go forward. And it's only your forwards that can do that.
Back and set.
They went missing in the first 40.
Newton to Tickle.
But look at that defence, Eddie. Our Leeds, yet again, take a step, hang back. They're confused. They're not confident going through.
This is the last tackle. That was a looping pass. The big kick downfield came from Radlinski. And Connolly will allow that to trickle its way over the dead ball line. Let's get the half-time news, Bill.
The words of Darryl Powell, room for improvements in his Leeds Rhinos side. And when I asked him where, he said, well, you name it. And he really was disappointed, I think, with aspects of that first 40 minutes. And he's looking for his side to really step things up in this second half. Led by Barry McDermott there, and take the game to the Wigan Warriors. As you can imagine, his opposite number, Stuart Raper, delighted with the enthusiasm and the commitment shown by his side in that first 40 minutes, and he just wants a continuation of that, and hoping that they can continue to put pressure on this lead side, just like that, and just cause them problems.
It was obviously reefed away. That should have been play on, because there was only one man in attendance at the particular time, and it was Hogg that reefed it away before the loose forward Nick Graham got involved.
Well, that was what Poaching was saying to Mr. Ganson, but the referee would have none of it.
Okay.
Lamb feeds the scrum, and here is Sean O'Loughlin. He's trying to go round Connolly. They're much quicker at the play of the ball, and that's Aspinwall who got through Connolly easier.
They're much quicker in every department, Eddie. All right, they sifted in two classic tries in that first half, but the way that they've bounced back, and they are bossing this game. Look at that. They're running at will.
Newton to Lamb. Here is David Hodgson. McKenna and Maguire with the tackle. Jamie Ainsco at dummy half. Adrian Lamb, Nick Graham. The runner was Sculthorpe. That's a big hit. A bigger part, it was Johnson. It was a big hit.
Hospital pass there.
And Paul Johnson felt it. Well, Auckland, that's a measured kick. And it's been dropped. This is going to be a trial.
No,
it would have been. Tickle has knocked it on.
Well, that probably would have been the end for Leeds. And I think he knows it as well.
Let's just check that.
It's a knock-on. But will it be the first one from Leeds? It probably will be. This would have been a try.
You'll have it right.
Oh, what a shame. He's really impressed me over the last couple of weeks. There's a second rower, Danny Tickle. I think that actually came from the winger, Francis Cummins. They want to find out to see whether it's a head and feet to Leeds. Well, that's hard to say. This is a knock-on, we know, but there's got to be decided which one was first.
Well, that's it. They're now trying to find out how to restart the game. No doubt it's no try, well, but is it head and feed Leeds or Wigan?
I think it's head and... I'm going to go head and feed Wigan. Attack inside.
We'll see. Here it comes. Scrum attack. Yes, you're right. Wigan have the opportunity. And that's why Steve Ganson handed it on, to make sure how to restart the match. But they were so close then to closing this game out, even this early in the second half, and they have a glorious opportunity here now with O'Loughlin and Leeds hanging back in defence. Radlinski!
Is that what you call it? It's far from defence as far as I'm concerned.
Newton.
Psychologically, they're just stunned.
Lamb, it lost it.
It's got to be a knock-on.
He got it back. He got it back.
Well, didn't he hit the man first? Didn't have to hit the ground.
This is Sculthorpe.
A little bit of luck there.
He offloads out the back door from Newton to Lamb. Graham. Graham gives it then to Gareth Hawk. And it's back to zero on the tackle count. He's wiped the tackle count clean, Steve Ganson. This is Adrian Lamb.
Good job, Ferner just got to him along with the hooker, Matt Diskin.
And they're asking for a knock-on against him. It's not given. That's nudged back. Oh, that is a gift for Leeds off Newton. Burrow did well. Here comes McDermott.
Well, at least they showed a lot of enthusiasm there. Rob Burrow said, this is mine.
They've escaped there.
Just dislodge it there. Good impact there from Sinfield.
Penalty against Wigan. Danny Sculthorpe, was it, who had a little punch at the grounded player?
Well, that was silly, wasn't it?
It was. There was little in it, to be fair, but Ganson...
Oh, he's got to go for that, surely. I know he was running low. Well, the official hasn't done anything about it. Ferner gets up and says, what's happening here?
Maguire, that's an awful pass, and that's a knock-on by Ainscope.
We'll take the first knock-on.
First knock-on,
well,
Wigan.
Ferner.
First one from
Wigan. Got a belter. Oh.
Leeds head and free.
And not, no official saw it.
Leeds head and free.
He went straight into him, and I'm telling you what, he should be off. Paul Johnson.
Andy.
He deliberately goes for
Andy
him.
Andy Johnson.
And then,
careful.
And it's no good. Steve Ganson's now saying, Andy, be careful.
He's got
be
the wrong careful. Name.
Oh, it's Andy Johnson that walloped Ferner.
No, it's Paul Johnson.
Paul Johnson.
He's got the wrong one. Senior.
That was high as well from Tickle. Well, Wigan, they don't need to do this.
This is McDermott.
They're in charge. By doing that, you know, it's going to fire Leeds back into the game.
Burrow, Maguire, and Bailey. That's high.
Well, this is silly. This could be a big turning point. All of a sudden, Leeds have been lolloping around thinking that the sun is shining. It isn't. It's getting dark. Take the shades off and get involved. And that was the least of the ones that we've seen. And Sculthorpe, I think, has every right, because I thought it was across the chest.
So that, take him the blood bin, mate.
And that was across the chest.
Take him the blood bin, please.
Well, that's payoff time. And Sculthorpe saying, hang on. And he's every right. But the sad thing for Wigan, and I'm sure Stuart Raper will say to him, look, calm down, fellas, we're leading.
Adrian, I've had one for a swinger and then one round the top. I don't want contact round the head. I give a penalty down here, another one down here. No, it wasn't, it was round the top.
And Ferner is on his way to the blood bin after the first challenge on him by Paul Johnson.
Well, they amaze me, these officials, you know.
Come on.
You get your nose broken, claret all over the place, play on, hit a bloke on the chest, and you penalise him. Is that payback time?
Leeds will try and take the 2 points on offer, and Sinfi looking to break his duck with the boot. Ferner's off and in the blood bin, and Chef Walker has come back. Sinfi then with this kick. Makes no mistake this time. 18 points to 10, though. It's still in Wigan's favour. And Stuart Raper knows that Wigan have generally always tended to beat Leeds when the chips are down. 94-95 Challenge Cup finals, the 95 Premiership final, the 98 Grand Final, of course, way back in 1983 with the old John Player Trophy final. The chips are certainly down tonight. The league leaders, the Leeds Rhinos, 100% record. It's on the line. High, hanging kickoff. Maguire is underneath it. Here is poaching. And that was a bit high, a bit lazy as well.
Stuart Raper has to get that message out, Eddie.
That was Paul Johnson.
But I mean, can you see? You can see what has happened to this Leeds outfit now. Swinging over the top. That's the second one, as you say. And this will give him the incentive. This is stoking the fire up.
Bailey driving in.
The Rhino was pretty quiet first 40.
And I tell you what, Bailey was in there with his knees up and tickle is flattened. Here is Sinfield, and here goes Gary Connolly. He's got support inside Maguire. He breaks the first tackle and Leeds score through the magical young Danny Maguire. Controversially left out of the Challenge Cup final, and Danny Maguire maintains this run of form. But way, way back at the other end of the field, Danny Tickle is receiving treatment. There were knees up in the tackle.
Certainly was, and quite a few players have been penalised for that. Tickle certainly felt it. Good work from Burrow. But look at the skill here. Sinfield's pass delayed. Full back, Connolly straight through. Soon as he broke away from the would-be tackler, it was always going to be 4 points. Well, this really should have been penalised, and Tickle would have felt that. But I've got to keep coming back to the fact, Eddie, that the tactics from Wigan have given Leeds the green light to go. When all they had to do was play basic rugby league football, they tried to prove how tough they were in the second half. Why is beyond belief.
Sinfield adds the extras. Leeds well and truly back in the hunt at 16-18. Just going back to that raised knee from Ryan Bailey as Danny Maguire's stats appear on your screen. Bradford Bulls will say that Stuart Fielden picked up a two-match ban for something like that, and there is supposed to be a clampdown on players raising their knees in the tackle. Well, Danny Tickle certainly felt that in his lower stomach. There's no doubt about that. The knee was well raised by Bailey. And Tickle, though, has recovered sufficiently to get this game back in motion. But they have been sucked in, Wigan, no doubt.
Well, I'm not so sure about being sucked in, Eddie, is the fact that they've set the plan. They've come out head-hunting. But all they had to do was do exactly what they did in the first half. Play good, solid, basic football. Forwards get that move forward. And then they started to say, listen, we can not only beat your rugby league football, we can show you how tough we are. All it's done is just got a big poking into the fire at Leeds, and off they go.
Danny Maguire ducking under a couple of challenges there. Just over halfway, plays it to Maguire. Here is Dooneman. This is Senior. That was an important challenge by Aspinwall. And Connolly dabs it down the line intelligently. Cummins trying to get the kick in. Radlinski stood his ground. That was great play both sides.
Wonderful stuff. And talk about a fullback saying, I am strong. I want to be in that position. But you just sense that Leeds now have got a whiff of it. And there looks to be a problem out wide there for a Wigan player. Is it Aspinwall? I'm not right sure. I can't just see him at the moment.
Lamb. Got the pass away. Graham, he got the pass away. Newton, it's been brave from him tonight. Lamb again. Certainly very much involved tonight, Adrian Lamb.
But the Leeds defence, a lot more eager. They're going forward, trying to get into their faces. They failed to do that in the first 40 minutes.
Newton, back it goes. Radlinski with a kick downfield and over the top. He's looking for a 40-20, just the wrong side of the corner of the post. What a great start to this second half, Phil.
Yeah, I agree with Steve-O. You know, I think the Wigan side have a walk on the sleeping rhino with a very sharp stick. Not only have they got it up out of bed, but they've also made it very, very irritable. And they're now intent on proving just how well they can play in this second half. I think Wigan always knew, though, that the Leeds side would come back at some stage. It's now how they respond to that. The period of a game has swung now in Leeds' favour. They've got to be able to withstand this pressure for a while before, no doubt, the tide turns in Wigan's favour. They get some quality possession back. And just go back to that point where you said about Ryan Bailey running there at Danny Tickle. Some may say that Paul Johnson should have been penalised for the high shot on David Furness, or who knows, they probably even themselves up at the end of the game.
Second, over
here. Burrow waited dummy half for the Rhinos. Well, there's Sinfield, wide to Walker. Come back to that in a sec, Steve, but let's see how this develops. OK, off you go.
Well, the point is that it will even itself out, but someone may have a back groin injury and the other bloke's got a broken nose.
Yeah, two wrongs do not make a right.
That's correct. Are you'd agree now?
Burrow. Good kick over the top. The speed out there for Leeds. That's a great kick almost. It just wouldn't sit up. But Burrow is thinking and scheming.
So is this fellow as well, Darrell Powell. And they've got a sniff of it. Remember, if it gets level pegging, could it be the third game on the row in Super League that Mr. Dooneman pops up with a wobbly one-pointer?
Wobbly or not, they all win the match. They certainly have done against Castleford and Wakefield. Come on, offside lads. Against Leeds now.
They'll be furious with that. Oh, Powell will be, that is for sure.
Got that, mate.
Never made any attempt to get.
Oh, that's a shocker.
Well done.
Didn't find touch with the kick. And Connolly to counter attack for Leeds.
First. Well, the crowd thought that was a flop, but it was the only one doing the tackle.
Here's Chef Walker.
Big effort from this kid to come back.
Second.
Shouldn't that have been a penalty? It looked like there was an arm inside the leg.
Bailey again.
He's made an impact, okay.
Quick play, the ball. Leeds have upped the ante. Here is Sinfield. That's poaching, but they were waiting for him.
Good play by Adrian Lamb. Knew that poaching was coming on that second phase. Picked him out.
Sinfield dabs it down the corner, looking for Calderwood. Radlinski tidies up for Wigan.
Keeping the pressure on. That's what the Rhinos are doing at the moment. And that's good work. They're working hard from the dummy markers, one and two.
Leeds 2 points away from the Wigan total at the moment. Their last home win against Wigan, 26-19, May 2000. Exactly 3 years ago. A more committed defensive show from them. Oh, good hit by Feather. Great hit by Feather, that was.
And all of a sudden, things are going right, aren't they? The enthusiasm.
Leeds head and feed, hang on.
If you stoke the fire, it gets hot. And when it gets hot, they start getting very excited indeed.
Dooneman. Dooneman delaying the pass, trying to go between the two men, tracked all the way there by Mark Smith. His 80th appearance for Wigan now that he's on. This is Danny Ward. Rob Burrow, dummy half. Danny Maguire, Feather, drives it in, 22 metres away. Burrow again. Here is Sinfield. Sinfield taking them on himself. Maguire and wide to Dunham. They've stacked the left-hand side, poaching. Big hit by Martin Aspinwall. Dunham. Maguire, little stab through, gobbled up by Paul Johnson.
But they're the right tactics. Just a little kick through, make sure it's not too long. You keep Wigan on their own line, not give them the opportunity. That was well weighted. OK, a Wigan player got to it in the end. But they've had three tackles and they've failed to get to that 30-metre line yet.
That's four gone, 23 metres gain. Newton, back it goes to Lamb. Wide it goes to Ainsco, taking on McKenna, nearly beating him. McKenna and Sinfield doing well in the end.
It's got to be a good kick from Wigan now, and a good chase.
A nice little nick over the top by Nick Graham. Well gobbled up by Sinfield.
Well, that's not what's needed. They needed to get into a position, and this has allowed Leeds now to get into the Wigan half so easily.
Danny Ward. Good offload to Connolly. Connolly back to Rob Burrow. Low centre of gravity, Burrow. Could have been a penalty there.
It should have been as well.
This is Dunham.
Maybe he's allowing the advantage.
No, he's just keeping the tackle count going. Here's Burrow again. It's now with Sinfield. Pops it up to Poaching. Comes down the middle, Poaching. Gets the ball away. Maguire clattered and loses it. Penalty.
No, he's brought it out. 2-on-1.
I think it was a bit of a high shot as well.
Bring Rob Burrow here.
Bonk.
Yeah, Nick Graham. Definitely pulled it out. You can see Rydlinski has got hold of him.
Yeah,
it would have been interesting to see if Rydlinski had released that leg.
Every time you tackle, you're down in play on. Penalties and waving your arms. Now I'm speaking to him about it. Next time I'll just go over and penalise him. Now it's down to you, mate. Okay, all right.
He's saying he's diving in at the legs, waving his arms, asking for a penalty.
Dive forward and suck a penalty out of me. I know what you're doing. Do it again, you watch out.
I don't think he's doing that. I think that's part and parcel of Rob Burrow's game.
All he wants to do is get on with the game.
What are you doing, mate? Two.
Well, he looks absolutely bemused, and so am I.
Well, he's got a right to look
bemused. And then he's just saying, well, the referee said...
You're trying to milk a penalty off me.
Well, all he wants to do is to go forward and then get up and play the ball quickly. The Wigan player prevents him from doing that, and then he blames the Leeds player. Ludicrous.
See, that's the way... This is Rob Burrow's game. He tries to... He's so small, he's got this low centre of gravity. He was trying to get on with the game there.
It doesn't matter if you're 24 stone. If someone's hanging on to you, there's no difference. They're going backwards. Mr. Cummings, if you're watching, which I'm sure you are, get it all sorted.
Sinfield's boot levels the scores, 18 apiece.
There was never going to be any doubt that Mr. Sinfield was going to go for 2 points there, was there?
Not at all. 18 all. Good stuff, though, isn't it?
Hey. I love it. I love it.
You're telling Mr. Cummings how to run the game?
No, I'm not.
You're criticising everybody that breathes.
I am requesting that he sorts it out. Over the past couple of weeks, there has been some shoddy displays by the man with a whistle. Some have been good.
You praised Robert Connolly yesterday.
That's what I said, some have been good. All right, he was pedantic once. I let him get away with one.
You didn't, you had a right go at him. Let's go down to Phil, get your view on the side, Phil.
Do you know, a very interesting stage in the game here now with 20 minutes to go, scores locked at 18-all. But one major difference between these two sides are the number of substitutes available. Leeds only have two left in the last 20 minutes as we see a massive decision here go against Leeds and a penalty there. You can see there the number of changes that Wigan have made, still eight left, and that could make a massive difference over the final 20 minutes.
Well, I don't know what this is for.
Well, what it's for is that Rob Burrow appealed for a penalty and he was told that he could not appeal for penalties anymore. He says, you do all that at me again. Keep your arms down, he's just said to Rob Burrow. They all do it. Mr. Ganson, I'm thinking you're getting it wrong.
So he's given a penalty because you're raising your arms. Well, anyone that does a high tackle, he should say, I'm penalising you because I've told you. Remember, this is the same guy that said, next one's in the bin, and then he said, oh, you've been good boys for 10 minutes, I'm not going to send you to the sin bin. This guy's taking over the game, never mind me. Rubbish comes to mind. And that's good Yorkshire speak.
Well, tickled with the opportunity here. Take a tablet, Steve, or just calm yourself down. Tickle, bang in front of the post, 30 metres out. He's not having Rob Burrow waving his arms at him anymore, he says. Tickle's got the 2 points.
Don't get me wrong, this is May, isn't it?
Yes.
Right, we saw yesterday...
Here, watch this.
Yeah. What's wrong with that? Right, and he's saying... And they said, listen, you've been a naughty boy, I've told you before.
Okay.
What do they want them to do? Well, strap their arms, strap their lips.
Well, Rob Burrow isn't the only one who does it, by the way.
They all do it.
Jimmy Lowe's does it every time Bradford are tackled.
It's part and parcel of the game. The adrenaline's bouncing through. You're 18 points each. What more does he expect? They're not angels. But I was trying to make the point that yesterday Christmas came early for Castleford and their coach gave him a rollicking, and yet they got away with a gift, 1 point. Now Christmas has come this way because Mr. Ganson has decided to get the wrappings going and put the little bows on top. Throw the mistletoe away, please.
Adrian Lamb, good kick, under pressure from Sinfield, but it will bounce into the arms of Connolly. Good chase from Wigan, though.
That's better. They just have gone to sleep for a while, and as I say, they were utilising the wrong tactics.
Second!
Which gave them an opportunity, Leeds, to get back in this match. Still plenty to go, though.
Danny Ward now over the halfway line for Leeds.
There's going to be plenty of twists and turns before the final whistle, I can assure you.
Maguire. Walker. One thing you can say about Steve Ganson, he gives us plenty to talk about, doesn't he? Feather.
It's not the referee that we should be talking about, is it?
No, you're right.
It's a skill. And when they come up with stupid
great kick
like that...
Cummings is after it!
What a take from Cummings!
Wonderful take from Carney.
Cummings was absolutely just barging through to him. Well, they're hanging on, this Wigan outfit. They've had very little possession in the Leeds half. Most of the time, they've been camped in their own quarter.
Come on.
And this will be an absolutely marvellous victory if they can hang on for this.
Lamb gets the ball away. And can Wigan hang on? Phil, what do you think?
Well, I look at one or two of the Wigan youngsters and they're looking at Adrian Lamb and saying, hey, you're a celebrity, get us out of here with 2 points. I think with this direction, if they continue with a completion rate and then look to a good kicking game, unusually though it's been kicked by Mark Smith, but still he's got great distance and managed to find some landing between the winger and full-back. That's all they need to do now for the remaining 50 minutes of this game. I say all, it's a lot easier sat on the sideline than it is out there. Players like Terry Newton now must be tiring. And when you've got the speed here...
From senior, he's got Radlinski to beat. He's got support from Rob Burrow, and Wigan won't stop this fellow. He's over under the sticks. Great try. Wonderful try from Burrow. But he's smiling now as Mr. Ganson gives him the four-pointer. What a wonderful bust. What great speed from senior. What sensational support from Burrow. That was worth the admission money alone.
That deserved 4 points, didn't it? They loved it. And so did the man that got penalised only a moment ago. But Connolly, they thought he was done, didn't they? Wigan said, we've got the best, we've had the best from Gary Connolly. He has come alive yet again. He started it. Those little legs were pumping through. On the blind side, what a pass. Carney was caught out of position. He's cool, this fella.
Great support play. Look at him go. Ding, 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 ding. Yes. This is what he meant to the coach.
And what he meant to all the Leeds supporters as well. Stuart Raper, of course, taking a different view. But a fabulous run from Rob Burrow. First try of the Super League campaign for him. And he won't score one much better than that.
Well, the quality of the Leeds tries tonight has been superb. It was only their defensive problems and mistakes in the first half.
Sinfield adds two more points. 24-20.
Big decision now for Wigan. What type of game will they go for now? Will they just grind it out and hope that they can maybe just kick into the in-goal area? They're looking a little bit dispirited and they're looking very tired indeed. As I mentioned, Eddie, they have had not much possession in the Leeds quarter.
What an exciting little player this is. Rob Burrow. 20 years of age. He was on as a sub three times against Wigan last year. And he got a try in the home defeat against Wigan in 2001. He will hope that that try here tonight will not turn into defeat. Leeds just ahead.
Well, it augurs well. Oh, what a mistake. What a mistake. I praise Gary Connolly, and he's come up with a boo-boo.
Hodgson inside to Gareth Hawk, and a chance for Wigan to counter here. It was off his ankle.
Yeah, but he should have got to that.
Adrian Lamb. Good run from Johnson. Offloads to Mark Smith. This is Aspinwall. Mark Smith, dummy half. Adrian Lamb. He's got Gareth Hawk with him. Was up round his neck, but he managed to get his hands to it. Hawk, maybe he should have been the dummy runner.
Good build-up from Wigan. They're looking dangerous.
Johnson enveloped by the tackler that was Chris McKenna. They're 5 metres away. Mark Smith, Nick Graham.
They nearly took the dummy there. Chris Feather just got back to it at the last moment.
Last one, Scunthorpe, he gets another try.
What an effort, what a score. Brilliant stuff.
Danny Scunthorpe's second try of the night. Just sheer power from 5 yards, scores a level.
Well, I hate to repeat myself, Eddie, but we keep saying it, but it keeps happening, doesn't it? One side scores a try and from the kickoff they go to sleep. And from the position there, he's had a big match, this fella. Not only in attack, but in defence. He's put himself about. Great stuff. Spinning round. That is sheer strength. Well, they didn't like it. Neither did he.
He liked it less.
And he knows it. And that came from that mistake.
Yes, Gary Connolly's bust on the left-hand side led to the try from Burrow. Gary Connolly's mistake has led to the try from Scunthorpe. Wow.
You know, you talk about psychology in sport. I wonder maybe whether a psychologist could get to some of these teams and say, the most important time is when you're basking in the glory of scoring a try. Group together. We see St. Helens many times when they've scored, they get in a huddle and they help themselves. Maybe other clubs should do exactly the same.
Change of kicker here for Wigan, Adrian Lamb. Oh, hello. Missed. Thought that was just going to scrape over. Change of kicker because Danny Tickle is off the field. 24-all.
When you get two sides of the fullback, Connolly, absolutely superb run to the blind, the offload. And then from the kickoff, just let it bounce the second go, and he knows it. He has paid the price. Creates six, gives away six.
Give away four. Missed the conversion.
Okay. First. A chance of six.
Correct. Well, we had a thrilling draw in the end yesterday at the Tigers, and we are now locked up at 24 apiece here at Headingley. Scunthorpe to Lamb. Graham, wide to Johnson, back on the inside to Ainscough. Goal.
This is brilliant stuff from Wigan.
Oh, Scunthorpe to Ainscough again. And in the end, Dooneman got to him.
You know, he frightens me, Ainscough, the way that he carries the football with one hand.
Mark Smith.
I know he's got
now then, are they within shooting range for a one-pointer?
They've got to go for it.
Lamb, no, he's hoisted it wide. It's a great kick, this. Oh, still on. It's still on. No, it isn't.
Oh, I don't think they realised it was back to six. I'm sure that a Leeds player touched that. Cummins did. He kept it alive, but they didn't realise. I think Tickle thought that that was the final tackle. It wasn't. It was being wiped by the official Steve Ganson. What a game. Well, the Leeds faithful, they have been given some wonderful, wonderful entertainment this year. Oh, why did he do that? Senior had already gone through the gap. A split second earlier, Senior would have got it. And it just overrun it.
And Briscoe swept on it for Wigan, and they will counter-attack. Well, we've seen Leeds with a couple of drop goals winning Super League matches this year already. But it's Wigan's turn to attack here with Hodgson. It's been high from McKenna.
Certainly was. Forwards, take it to the base of the sticks.
Lamb.
He knows it now then. One more drive. One more drive and then Mr. Lamb, surely.
They've come this way with Graham. And Graham dabs the kick through. And Calderwood hammers it out. And over the dead ball line. And Stuart Raper wants a message on.
I know what that message is.
Drop a goal.
When they drop the goal ball out, take it forward. Do not start trying to run to the left or the right.
Drive. And he went straight to Adrian Lamb, did Nigel Astley-Jones.
Drive of Farrow right the way through to the lead sticks.
So the word from the coach to his captain. There's the dropout, good length on it to be fair, over halfway. Tickle then to run this ball back. And Ferner.
Well, both sides, they're running out of gas now.
That's good first thinking. Goal line dropout there we've just seen from Leeds. First of the match. 73 minutes or thereabouts, we're on the way.
Forward.
Scunthorpe on the charge. He's on a hat-trick, remember?
He's had a great
Danny game. Scunthorpe. We normally talk about his brother, Paul, in those terms, don't we? Here's Lamb. Good ball. Briscoe ducks underneath one challenge. Now then, they're in with
a
shout here. No.
Oh, what are they doing?
Graham. Nick Graham. Haul down.
Well, now they're out to the left. It's going to make the drop goal a lot more trickier.
Lamb. Just dinked inside one.
Missed it.
Missed it.
Why on earth did they go on there to the left-hand side? When all they had to do was just keep going towards the sticks. I know one thing. If Leeds get the opportunity, there'll be a certain Mr. Dooneman will make sure that they go up to the sticks. Oh, that is a bitter penalty to give away.
Tickle all over the top of Senior, and he was claiming Tickle was, that Senior was kicking out with the leg.
Oh, well, you can't do that, because if he raises his arm and complains again, he'll get penalised.
Come on, Danny!
So this is a chance for Leeds now, and McDermott's on!
What a time to bring back the big fella as well.
Here's Maguire, here is Bailey!
Another drive! Go early, they probably won't be expecting it.
Sinfield, he takes it towards the posts. They're 18 metres away. Dooneman's hanging back, so is Maguire. It's with Maguire. Danny Maguire hits the post.
Oh, what an unbelievable. They did everything right, apart from the fact it didn't go 2 inches to the right. Well, who would have thought within the space of 2 days we could finish up with two draws, and it's likely. It was just banging away there. It hits the post. What a match this has been.
Terrific stuff, isn't it? The two of the biggest names in the game, Leeds and Wigan. Leeds, who have used up all their substitutions, so they have to now stick with what is out there. But two of the biggest names in the game producing an absolute thriller at Headingley. And Lamb hoists the kick downfield. Cummins will catch it. Now then, We're in for a big last five, Phil, aren't we?
We certainly are, and I would say probably Leeds have used up their luck. You know, they've won the last two games by just that single point, as you've highlighted. So I've just got a sneaky feeling, and probably on the work rate as well today, that Wigan just deserve to get more than a single point from this. They just seem to be the hungrier side, the side with more enthusiasm, and the side, if anything, that could maybe just come up with a big play. Just look how quicker their line's going up. Having said that, there's so much class in these Leeds Rhinos, it's hard to pick against them.
It is, and we have just 4 minutes remaining here at Headingley, and here comes Dunaman, and there is Ferner. It's the last tackle. It's a great defensive stint here from Wigan, and Dunaman just hoists the kick downfield. Now then, Dunaman's chasing this, and that will hang in the in-goal area. There's a job to do here for Carney, and he does it brilliantly.
Look how tired Leeds are. There was only one man that could get anywhere near Carney then, and he dug deep. They're out on the feet, both sides. Well, we thought it was going to be a classic, and it certainly has turned out that way.
And don't forget, Leeds are involved in our next match on Sky Sports down in the capital against the London Broncos. Tony Ray here tonight to watch this. And I bet he's delighted that Leeds are being taken to the absolute limit by the Wigan Warriors. Lamb, inside it goes to Briscoe. He's lost it.
Knock on. That could be a vital moment. Gary Connolly.
Leeds had a feed.
Former Wigan player.
That's good tackle by another former Wigan player, Ferner.
Well, that's a new rule coming into play yet again. That's the reason why Briscoe was saying, well, it was knocked out.
Come on.
It probably was.
Come on, lads, lock in.
But that new rule states if you're going for the tackle, it's up to the ball carrier to have control of it.
Here's McKenna. Have Leeds got something left in the tank? A couple of minutes remaining.
This is where the forwards have to come to the fore. Connie's had a big game as well. There's been so many heroes. OK, he was a villain at one point.
Well, Leeds won it against Wakefield on Friday with the very last play of the game. They're intent, though, on keeping this ball alive. Burrow, though, is flung to the ground by Aspinwall. There's Dunaman. Here is Bailey.
Can they get the strength to take another drive?
Burrow going down the left-hand side. McDermott to Senior, great tackle again by Radlinski.
This is the last,
Dunaman again. He's running it this time. He's running round in circles. He's going for the 1 point again. He's just sliced it wide.
Oh, it's a bad bounce.
It's a shocker for Ainscough.
Did he wobble it? Touch check says no. Leeds fans go absolutely bananas. It certainly looked as though it took a little bit of a wobble. We'll see it here. It was an awful bounce, wasn't it? Oh,
he did well.
He did well there. It did bobble, but it didn't hit the ground.
Square on
Leeds hunting a mistake from Wigan. Late in the game, deep in Wigan territory.
Still
that's
a chance.
Four gone.
Still a chance for both sides. It has to be a good kick. What an effort this kid's had today.
Skill pulls were magnificent.
As he ever. And not surprisingly, he's taking his time. It's got to be a good kick and chase.
Lamb hoofs it towards the corner.
Let it go.
It will skip dead.
Don't mess around, Gary. This will be the final throw of the dice. Oh, they're messing around. Wigan won't rush for it.
He's held the clock up.
Okay.
Well, it looks like Leeds are still going to be undefeated.
Well, this is the last.
Super League.
This is the last minute. The last throw of the dice.
Got to keep it going.
Second.
37 seconds.
Don't give a penalty away, Wigan. That's what Stuart Raper's yelling out.
Burrow can't get through.
It's getting to the point where it's kick and chase time.
Dunaman, Ferner. Desperate to get over that halfway line.
One more drive.
18 seconds remaining. Connolly.
They can just get one more play, the ball in, and that's about it.
Last one.
They've got to go for it. Who's there?
Dunaman. Sinfield. White. Oh, he went backwards though. Calderwood. It's going to end the draw, this. It's going to end the draw. That was a forward pass. And it's a draw. Well, we've waited all season for the first. We've got two in 24 hours.
Well done, mate.
24 points apiece. A fantastic match at Headingley. Another wonderful advert for the Tetley Super League. Wigan have played their full part. This team that has been shorn of the likes of Dallas, Craig Smith, Mick Cassidy, Andy Farrell, Stephen Weil, Luke Robinson and Ricky Bybee. They just keep on going. They don't know what the word defeat means. And Leeds still don't know what defeat means, because though they've lost their 100% record, they've been taken closer than anyone here today. It's Wigan's first league draw here since 1987. 24 points apiece. Well, David Ferner shaking hands and sharing words, and he's bloodied but unbowed, is Ferner, against his former club. Bill Arthur is now on the side with the Wigan coach, Stuart Raper.
Stuart, I think your expression says it all. Is that frustration or admiration?
Oh, admiration for our guys. I mean, you know, a lot of people don't think we've got the goods. We've had a lot of players out. In the last 3 weeks, we've played the three top sides. We've had a draw, we've been beaten on the bell, and we've beaten, you know, we've beat Saints. So I'm really proud of these guys and the effort they put in tonight.
And for a club in crisis, allegedly, that's another heroic performance.
We're not in crisis, we're far from it. We've got some injuries, but guys keep putting their hands up and playing with these battle wounds and doing their club and their town proud.
Well, let's bring one of them in, because he got man of the match. I don't know what you think about this. How's this for a choice? Danny Sculthorpe.
Good choice, he worked hard, as did a lot of other guys.
Well, let's bring him in. He's the man of the match, Danny Sculthorpe. We got your breath back.
No, I'm absolutely knackered. That was unbelievable. So fast that I've never played as long in my life.
Now, I think going into this game, given the injuries that Wigan had got and the problems the club has had, everybody was thinking that you were in for a hiding here tonight. I suppose that was just the motivation, wasn't it?
Well, the fans might have thought that, but the players, we knew we could come here, get 2 points, end up getting one. But I think we'll be happy with that.
But in those closing minutes, what was it like? As you say, it must have been one of the longest 80 minutes.
In the last 3 minutes, felt like 80 minutes. It was just, I just couldn't breathe, running on nothing.
Well, brother Paul's got plenty of these watches, so your turn tonight, well done.
Yeah, thank you, thanks. Thanks to T-Saw as well for the watches. There you go.
Well, that's the way it ended. Full time, 24 points each. A great second half. A pretty good first half as well. But what an advert again for this wonderful competition that is the Super League. 26 all yesterday at Castleford against Hull. 24 points apiece here at Headingley, Leeds against Wigan. Leeds, they maintain their unbeaten record, but no longer can they say they are 100%. They've dropped their first point of the Super League season. Leeds then stay on top. They're 3 points clear now of the Bradford Bulls. It's Bradford and London. That's the game in hand from round seven that still has to be played. Hull are now third, St Helens fourth, Castleford and Warrington. And, it's a terrific competition, isn't it? And that first half and second half here at Headingley tonight really has emphasised exactly what this great game is all about. And the players, Phil Clark, they've earned every penny over this bank holiday weekend, haven't they?
I'd agree fully with that, you know, and I think we also recognise the fact now that names and reputation mean very little in rugby league. It's attitude and application that prove whether or not you're a top player, and the attitude and application from the Wigan sides over the last few days is fantastic. I thought the way they responded to a very, very tiring defeat against Bradford, really, one that would emotionally drain them to lose in the last couple of minutes, was fantastic here today. They came out, and with that sort of resolution, really, they may push sides all the way throughout this Tetley Super League. I think they've proved, probably whilst missing some of the more recognisable names, they're actually playing the best rugby of the season so far in the last three games. They got off to a poor start in the first five matches, but since then, they've now started to put things together. And I think one or two teams watching, and especially their coaches here as they've watched the game, will just worry a little bit more about Wigan. For Leeds, really, they've got to pick themselves back up and get ready for another tough challenge in London at the weekend.
Indeed so. You have to wonder what will happen when Wigan get Farrell and Cassidy and Craig Smith and Brett Dallas back. It's a terrific season for Wigan, and it could still be. They could still end up at Old Trafford in the grand final. Leeds, though, They're top of the table. They are 3 points clear. I wonder how Darryl Powell has taken this draw. Let's hear from him. He's with Bill.
Darryl's still unbeaten, still top, but that must be hard to take.
We looked as though we were under pressure at half-time, but I thought second half we came out and we played like we know we can. We upped the tempo a little bit. Our goal forward was a lot better, and things happened on the back of getting good goal forward. So I thought we straightened our game out at half-time. Really pleased with the boys coming up with a result when it looked like we might not do. So it was a top-quality second-half performance.
There was a bit of lethargy first half, wasn't there? That took a bit of while to get going.
Yeah, I don't think we turned up in the first half, and a lot, big parts of our game were pretty ordinary. But as I say, we fixed it up, and I think that's important that you can fix things up. And they showed a lot of courage and commitment again, and got a result. And we were very close to winning it there again, weren't we? But yeah, that'd be more than 2 points in our last five games, and they're pretty tough to watch at times.
Thanks, Darryl. They're exciting, though.
Oh yeah, they certainly are. Cheers, mate.
They're fantastic. Well done, Darryl. Well said. And, of course, they face a tiring journey now to London on Thursday, preparing for the match against the Broncos on Friday. Ooh, let's draw breath and look at this bank holiday weekend and look at this match in particular, Steve-O. Fabulous advert again.
Oh, without a doubt. OK, maybe a little bit scrappy, especially if you're a Leeds fan in that first 40 minutes, but Darryl Powell has made it quite clear that once he got to his charges at the break, they were going to be in it. But I think that they were going to be absolutely knocked out cold if this try would have been allowed. Now, Cummings definitely got to it, and Tickle, no one in front of him, just got a little bit excited. Now, this is the tackle on Ferner. This, I think, is a turning point. And then the one hit on the shoulder, I think that was a squared up by the referee, Steve Ganson, and he's saying, well, hang on, I hit him on the shoulder. Absolutely wrong tactics by this Wigan outfit. And then Leeds, they just break into it, don't they? Back on the inside. That was superb passing. Absolutely wonderful. And then again, Connolly. Wasn't he a hero here? Offloaded it. Senior back on the inside. And look at the legs on this fella. Super sub, they want to call him. He's all talent. And it looked as though they were going to run away with it. And I mean that. Until man of the match, Sculthorpe. He had a wow of a game. You know, he gets overshadowed by some of the Wigan stars. Now, this is the incident where he goes forward. Now, I think this should have been a penalty. There's no doubt in my mind that he's being held back. And yet, the referee warns him and says, look, I am not satisfied. I'll tell you what he's not satisfied with, diving when someone's hanging onto your legs. Now, don't be a naughty boy. If you do it again and raise your arms, I'm going to penalise you. A very controversial penalty indeed. And I think it's one, and I think that the referees board should have a look at Ganson and say, what on earth is he doing? He's bringing new rules into our game. Why? I've never seen that done before. And I tell you what, Darryl Powell has every right to be spitting chips over that decision.
Well, he might be a little bit concerned about the decision, and you most certainly were, but he will be well pleased with the point that Leeds have got. And I'm sure that Stuart Raper also will go home tonight and feel well satisfied with the point he has got from Headingley here. We'll see you at London on Friday. Hope so. Great try! Sculthorpe! 24 points apiece.